What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Jynx BK. Now, let me just tell y'all something, man. We happy over here in West Virginia right now. A little bit of two reasons. I'm going to tell you one. One, our football team isn't looking half bad right now. I don't know if I want to say it's to Coach Neil Brown or if it's to players, but the fans is okay with it. Now, that also being said, this music thing, man, we've been on a journey of music for a minute with you guys, all right? Now, the people that are new to the channel, I just want to say thank you, number one. But number two, I have definitely been on YouTube now for a little bit over a year, all right? I lost my first channel due to a really crazy mistake that I made on another social media platform, and I was hacked, and I lost all of my emails. I had, like, literally, basically had to check everything and restart everything, like, down to, like, my bank account was getting screwed with by this person, all right? That's how crazy it got. So I had to definitely restart everything, but it humbled me. I'm okay with that. The numbers went down, but that's okay because we all have to start somewhere, and God is good to me, so I'm going to have to just keep on motherfucking trucking. You heard me? Now, this new artist right here, new artist alert. I don't know about this cat. Elliot Smith, number one, put in the comments what band he's from, or she. Number two, what is this song Between the Bars about? Number three, if I cry, who do I need like an email to people who request these songs. Because I would take the time to send you a frowny face if you make me cry. With the fish too. You know what it means. We fight over here. Let's get into it, man.
Drink up, baby. Stay up all night with the things you can do.
Wait. What? Now, you ain't about to just start some crazy vocals like that. Did y'all hearing this, right? Take a second and tell the kids to shut up. Turn the TV down. Stop everything and just listen for a second. This man's voice is ridiculous. Wait a minute. Am I all the way up? Yeah, I'm all the way up. Okay. Wait, y'all.
Drink up, baby, stay up all night with the things you could do. You won't, but you might. The potential you'll be that you'll never see. The promises you'll only make. Drink up with me now. The thing all about the pressure.
Wait a minute, like, where is this coming from? Like, this is, like, I don't... Depression, right? I gotta look up the lyric sheet and go back through this. But this is, like, some dark shit right here. Some deep shit. What happened? What happened to this boy?
You'll be that you'll never see. The promises you'll only make. Drink up with me now. Forget
this reminds me of, like, this is like some suicidal thing. This is crazy. I don't want to judge this, man, because people do write stories that aren't about them in songs. But if this happened to him, y'all have got to let me know down below what this is about, like, for real. Or who, rather. If it's a real story, if it's something that's just, you know, made up through expression because this guy's been through some crazy times, which I've written some crazy things. You know, one of these days I'm going to release my book or books, and I feel like people are going to relate to them just because of, you know, time is screwed for some of us, man. We definitely have a lot of hard times in our life. Each of us individually have our own different hardships, but there is hard times in there, regardless of how much of a good background you and your family might have. I can say honestly, my mama, she took care of me and my sister, all right? My grandmother, but she was my mama to me. I didn't know we were poor. Let's just say that. I didn't know we were poor, you know? I felt bad for my neighbors at one point because they had less for a Christmas, and I never forget their Christmas tree had like 3 gifts under it, and I had actually got in trouble by my mama because I had taken me and some of my sister's gifts over there. Now, they had opened them up prior to her understanding, but she didn't know that, you know, that I had done that ahead of time. But when they had opened them up and she had seen that they was playing with them and everything else, she had let it slide. But listen, when they left, she corrected me and she said, hey, listen, sometimes you just can't do for other people, but to feel bad, I completely understand, and that's why you're not punished. So I've always had a good heart like that, but this, it's irrelevant to this, but I'm saying, like, that's, why is this song making me think like this? Or is it the weed? Or is it ADHD? good times, old times, memories, man. What can we say, right? I just want to know what this is about or who, because people go through some crazy shit, and I tell you, like, people just go through some crazy shit, bro. Sorry. The realest reactions of the planet, man. I'm not editing this shit out because I feel like if people edit their shit out, motherfuckers would be like, yo, they're phony. This is why their reactions suck. They're all the fucking same. Nah, bullshit. My shit's different than anybody the fuck else. It ain't because of my language. I don't give a fuck about that. You could probably edit my shit out if you really wanted to. I don't know. I'm not going to. I have no filter, and it's just the way that I want to live. So love me because I'm a nice guy and I love you, or hate me because my language is crazy, man. But it is what it is. We out here.
Just stuck in your head. People, you've been before that you don't want around anymore. They push and shove and walk into your will. I'll keep them still. Drink up, baby. Look at the stars, I'll kiss you again. Between the bars where I'm seeing you there, with your hands in the air, waiting to finally be caught. Drink it one more time, and I'll make you mine.
Wow.
Keep you
warm. There's just a lot to this, like. That's just beautiful, man. I can't help it. It's one of those songs that just make you want to just sing along with everybody. Like, you know the lyrics for days and days. But I've never heard that before, and it made me rant. Like, you know, I didn't want to. I didn't want to get on here and talk about some memories from me doing some crazy shit when I was 8, 9, 10 years old, whatever it was, yo. That's crazy. I don't know. Maybe I need to quit smoking weed for, like, a good minute. It's like, it's been on my mind recently too, like, for a lot of reasons. I don't know. You know what? Maybe I just need to chill out because I be thinking too hard about shit sometimes, all right? I just got this book called Stop Overthinking, and, man, 23 ways to help you stop overthinking, to be exact. Wow. So we're going to see what that really helps me with, man, because, like, y'all can tell these reactions unedited. This is the realest you can get, yo. All right. So now you might understand why I got that book. I don't know. Some of y'all are more advanced in life than I am. So you might have a higher education and see something I don't even see. I don't know, bro. But I tell you what, man. I can only give you what I feel, man. And that's just me, man. We out here. One love.